joining us on the program. I'm Millicent Walker. We begin with prominent opposition figure in Kenya, Miguna Miguna, who has been deported from the country again. This is part of an ongoing row over his citizenship status. Kenyan officials had previously expelled Mr. Miguna following his role in the mock swearing-in of opposition leader Raila Odinga as the people's president. Mr. Miguna was detained earlier this week after attempting to re-enter Kenya. According to Kenyan officials, Miguna, who holds dual nationality, is not a citizen. But Mr. Miguna, who was flown to Dubai, says their motives are political. He has now appealed for help through his social media account. On his Facebook page, he said, quote, "I was dragged, assaulted, drugged and forcefully flown to Dubai. I woke up in Dubai and the despots are here insisting that I must travel on to London. I am being threatened and want to fly to Nairobi and nowhere else. I am sick. My ribs and body is hurting all over. This is a travesty of justice." End of quote. Well, let's talk to our lawyer and African affairs analyst who is in the studio, Ms. Yinka Oyeniji. A pleasure to have you on the program.
Good evening, ma'am.
What do you think? Miguna says he was beaten, drugged, being forcibly sent out from Kenya airport to Dubai. Why has he been refused entry into Kenya, even though various courts have said that he should be brought back?
All right, well, according to the government of Kenya, Mr. Miguna purportedly holds a dual citizenship, okay? That's that of Canada and that of Kenya. Kenya by birth, Canada by naturalization, far back about in the 90s. Now, the government continues to state that as of 1992, when Miguna took up Canadian citizenship, there was no provision in the Constitution for holding dual citizenship. So the government proposes to say that he had forfeited his Kenyan citizenship as of that time. That being the case, even though he had been issued a Kenyan passport, the government has said he must go through the process of naturalizing back to become a Kenyan and then validly hold dual citizenship. So even though it would seem to the naked eye that he is he's been involved in illegal and unconstitutional activities, the legitimate reason for the government is that he holds a dual citizenship, which is illegal.
But even though the court is saying this, I mean, the Chief Justice, David Maraga, criticized government over disobeying court orders. It's not the first time we've also seen public office holders disobeying court orders. But what do you make of this? Isn't this inimical to the rule of law?
All right, first of all, for Kenya itself, Miguna himself participated in the greatest affront to the Constitution, which he purports to hide under right now. Now, there was a swearing in, an illegal, unconstitutional swearing in of someone who did not even contest the last batch of elections that saw Kenyatta in as a new president. Now, that is treasonable felony in itself, truthfully, okay? Now, if you've done that, ordinarily, they have been magnanimous to him by having him deported. He should be facing that same court. So the government looks at it to say that you can't come to equity except you are coming with clean hands yourself. You are purportedly committed treasonable felony. You should be made, all right, to face the music of that. Other than saying that you've, again, your lawyers have gone to court and have secured court orders, you won't necessarily think that the government will be ready to obey such orders when he himself has committed the highest possible offense that anybody can commit under rule of law.
But where is equity when Raila Odinga, you know, agreed with Mr. President Uhuru Kenyatta, the unity agreement, you know, to uphold the rule of law in this regard?
And that is it again. Now, we are talking about, for everything that we do, including the Federal Republic of Nigeria, at some point you consider the peace. There's no doubt about that. Now, those two leaders, the president who has been re-elected and the main opposition who has accepted that for the peace of Kenya and all of that, that everybody should move on. Now, everyone in their ranks must be seen to be towing that line. Now, for Miguna himself, he's gone again and again. It's not the first time he's been arrested. As far back as 1989, he's been holding government to ransom. All right, so now he's been on the side of the president before. He's now on the side of the opposition leader. The opposition leader is in cooperation with the sitting president, yet Miguna wants to become the third force. Nobody's looking for a third force in Kenya. And that's why a lot of people are not taking to the streets yet, because they'd rather wait for Odinga to show them the way to go than a Miguna coming to cause more problems when they want to settle down to governance.
Do you see a brewing conflict between the Kenyan government and the judiciary?
It's not going to happen.
Forward?
It's not going to happen. What's going to happen is that there are going to be amendments to the Constitution of Kenya and all of that. Everybody knows this man came out. He was the one who signed the oath of office, which the opposition leader took to say the mock swearing in. So everybody knows the way to go. If he knows the way to go is to go back to Odinga and say to him, Odinga, plead my case and let's have peace in Kenya. Going abroad, and that's why the international community is not doing much other than to guarantee his own safety and his good health. Other than that, everybody wants to move on. 150 people lost their lives after that elections in November last year. Nobody wants to lose any more life. So he had better just get his acts together and hope that Odinga will plead his case.
So looking at the future of Miguna Miguna now, does he have a right to return to Kenya? What's going to happen?
Unfortunately, he won't be able to get into Kenya. There's no doubt about that. The government has said to him, we can put together your citizenship. We can give you, they've availed him the forms. They told him he will fill it. Your national ID card will not get you into Kenya. So he has to go back to the way of validly holding the dual citizenship. And I'm sure he's also eyeing the government, he's eyeing power. And to become validly elected in Kenya, he would have to go through that naturalization process.
All right. Thank you so much. We've been talking to Mr. Yinka Oyeniji, a lawyer and African affairs analyst on the issue.
It's my pleasure. Thank you very much.